What can I do for you? It's not something I'm good. The way she looks at everything with those big eyes. She may seem to be just like you and me, but I think she is quite different.
Really? I was just following directions. This grand assault kind of action is not really my thing.
I don't like improvising.
Wasn't really my...
You know, Yulia, I don't want to be the center of attention. I want to be in control of my life and other people's lives.
I think deep down, I always was.
Thank you for leaving.
At your service, Legate. I don't like... That being said, I get the feeling this young woman is a bit different. These Sherthians can be...
What have you found? This is... It could... If we can get our hands on some substantial evidence, we can destroy Watelia Skyewala once and for all.
Ready to deploy the Legion. Aetina Rapivia,
our Legion has engaged the enemy.
Yakete Pila! One of our maniples is about to fight! Contendite Vestas! This is it! Their will to fight is broken!
Sinite milites exultare!
Please, excuse me. Salve, Domina.
I finished that equipment you requested. Turned out all right, if I do say so myself. You can collect it right. Over here.
So Freck here has decided they want their asses...
Our way, Legate.
Fine by me.
All quiet.
Chips sold separately.
Hello again. Glad to see you back. How can I help you tonight? It's not what I usually sell, but I'm not going to pass up a good offer. I have no other... I have... Oh, he'll be pleased to hear I sold his honey for such...
This looks like the place. That must be the smuggler down by the pier. Shall we go and have a chat?
We've been discovered! Drop those things! Attack them!
I am not... Ah, Jupiter, take it all. How do you know my name? I'm not telling you a thing. You can piss right off, or my people and I will... You think I can be intimidated that easily?
No, don't! Anthea, you sick bastard!
What do you want?
Isn't it obvious? Vitellius Gaevola owns it. He shares there's a hidden cave on the coast near Chalcedon where If I take you to the galley, the soldiers will empty the cave. If I take you to the cave, the ship will leave. It's not about how quiet we are. I just completed it. The soldiers will have started to move the goods, and the ship is preparing to leave. There is no time. You're sure?
If we don't bring home any evidence against Gaevola, your sister will be stuck
with
him.
I want you to get your villa back and restore your name.
A lot of good Romans will die if we don't stop those supplies.
As you wish. Hide yourselves on my boat.
Good. They are still here.
Corwinus actually told us the truth. I was honest...
They haven't noticed us yet, and they seem quite spread out. If we're careful, we may be able to defeat them in detail. We'll find a way to get your villa back.
Every Pontic soldier we kill...
Thank you.
Gets them every time.
A feeble old man.
Over here, help!
No permanent damage. Request some help, please.
It's only a scratch, you big baby.
Are we sure this is best way to go? Look ahead. We're coming to them from below.
This has the stink of a last stand about it. I don't like it.
You think this is about weathering a siege?
What else?
These supplies will stop at Castle across the water. That way, Mithridates can safely retreat if the Romans take Arcadum.
Thank you. for your land, or you will die a slave in Rome. Stand your ground. Let them come to
follow me.
Follow my finger. Yes, you'll be all right.
Are you all right?
I can't take this anymore.
Hey, it's me! I'm here!
Stand still. I've got you.
I need aid soon, lest I perish.
You are mostly fine. Get back into the fight.
shadow.
Problem here.
It's all right. You're going to live. Please follow my finger. Yes, you'll be all right.
Couldn't have done it better myself!
Thank you.
yourselves! The gods will carry us to victory! You think you'll catch me? Think again!
Is anyone gonna help me?
No permanent damage.
I need a hand!
Does this hurt? Good, that means you're fine.
No mercy!
There, see? It's not so bad.
Almost at the end of this, it seems.
So many crates. I can't believe Skywalla has delivered all this to Mithridates right under our noses.
It is a tendency I have observed many times throughout.
Certainly, Legate.
After the war is done, let's go together to Pompeii. I'll take you to the Lupinare Grande. The girls there are worth a trip.
Thank you for sending me those schematics your people found. I've made a list of materials needed, whenever you have a moment to go over it.
The end of the
war is near. I can feel it.
Should we position the troops?
Alicite hostes in informatam.
The men are close enough to engage.
All is well, I hope.
That was amazing. I don't even eat this well.
We got him cornered.
It was all meant for Mithridates.
Let's go.
You have literally feasted like a king.
We're in the process of sending an official to run this newly conquered region. But the speculatories have warned us of an assassination attempt. Maybe. That is, no one. The assassins will...
Our way, Legate.
At your service.
Good night.
Thank you for sending me those schematics your people found.
Good night.
I've made a... List of materials needed. Whenever you have a moment to go over it.
Your money or your lives? I will not ask again.
By Zeus, look at you!
here now.
I knew it! They've come to kill me! Help! Don't let them get me!
Never see this coming. My friends, I'll cover you.
Save you!
should have surrendered.
Just as planned, they walk into our trap.
me, friends.
No permanent damage.
Shall vanquish our enemies.
You are mostly fine. Get back into the fight.
Thank you. knew it! They've come to kill me! Help! Don't let them get me!
Forth, my
like a shadow.
Man, Mars, help me!
We're here to save you!
I may be in a bit of trouble.
No permanent damage.
I see them. Let's get those bastards. Artemis, steady my hand and guide my arrow to the heart of my enemy.
live for Rose, and I shall die for her.
We're nearly done.
Stand still. I've got you.
Come on, this way.
Watch carefully.
The end is in sight, but don't let down.
These the guys we are beating up?
Too strong!
away, Legato.
Legate, we have taken Nicomedes. I am told that if I would say there is no urgency if you have any. As you wish.
Salve, Domina. Need something?
Legate, I expect the consul
need something.
Good day.
I heard in Rome, women change color of their... hair? Maybe I will get a different color in Rome.
Like what?
How about... yellow? Is it possible?
Trust me, Dayanara.
The day has arrived. Chalcedon must fall today, or we may lose Carter and whatever remains of his forces.
I've heard Gadzar.
That is exactly why a frontal assault is what we will use. That is that initial Mithridates. That's when our small team of speculatories sneaks into the city.
Our scouts discovered a less
aim.
We'll need to take either that.
The more of let us
that does not small.
While the Legion let us hope for the best. But you may not without the
take him out.
It's up to it is up to you.
Make sh-
make
more
come on.
For once, I agree with the big guy.
hand, or you will die a slave in Rome. As soon as I see them, I shoot.
Get over there! Advance! Follow me!
Hold them there. I'll circle around.
Standing. Impressive.
This is all too easy. Other way.
Artemis, steady my hand and guide my arrow. We will wait here for the enemy to come.
Like that, did you?
Ah!
Perhaps I need someone to help me here.
You are mostly fine. Get back into the fight.
Me, friends.
Please follow my finger. Yes, you'll be all right.
Formation, slow and steady. Medicate.
It's all right. You're going to live. Can anyone heal the healer?
Rise and know your strength.
Oh.
some attention.
Does this hurt? Good, that means you're fine. Please follow my finger. Yes, you'll be all right.
Handle this alone, if I must.
No permanent damage.
Because it means now.
Release the catapults!
Hang on, friends! We're here to save you! We have successfully started the assault. Let's get back behind our own walls before the catapults strike.
Soon, lest I perish.
Does this hurt? Good, that means you're fine. To live.
No, we're here yet. That won't last. Stay low, but be ready to fight.
Well, I joined the wrestling team. I thought it would be fun. He said it wasn't. It was really, really hard work, but I loved it. That's kind of what jives with what he's good at. He likes that grind.
See, there it is. Beautiful work. I mean, the right hand connected on Maximo.
Yeah.
And then he went for the takedown. And I think Bruno was waiting for the shot. You know, when I say the shot, I mean the wrestling shot. But he caught it with the right hand, and then he threw. That's a powerful kick as well.
Second UFC appearance for Nick Maximo, who fought an international fight meeting against Cody Brundage. Got the victory over some three hard rounds.
Nice right hand there. Yeah, that right hand is money. Nice work there from Soriano to defend that takedown. Reaching under that leg, threw him over to the side. Good defense. Wish DC was here to kind of break it down a little better than myself.
These guys high-level wrestlers.
Sick of hearing him and his wrestling prowess. Get it. You're good. But right here, you know.
Cover. Let's take those catapults apart and get out of here.
Thank you.
handle this alone, if I must.
You're welcome.
They've lost their mind!
Somebody stop them, they're killing me!
I'm out of here.
I thought we were safe here.
Show them our strength.
time. We have done what we can. Now we go to Kotak.
Looks like there's only one or two catapults still able to shoot. The other team did their job well. Form up on me! Let's take that city!
Drone in. Oh, hey. That's your style, that's your style.
Yeah, it's gotta be frustrating for Kuna right now. He just wants separation, but Maximov doing a great job not allowing him to have that. These are nice knees to the thigh, too. They don't feel nice.
They hurt. Big
that's
time.
Right, and that's right along the IT with the IT man. Is that what it
the
is?
The IT man.
That sucks, man.
You know. You're all
my pure screen. Is he Nate Diaz?
That's what I roll out of my foam rollers for my long runs. You know what I mean?
Oh, God, stop it.
For my tempo runs. Before I do a fault lick, it's actually the name of a run.
I know.
You've heard him?
Yeah.
All right, Michael. I see you doing those hill reps.
Come on.
Oh, there's another one. Yeah, something's bothering him.
Something's hurt.
He's hurt. Nobody's ever taken him down in this his fourth UFC appearance or on the Contender Series. He's reversing it here. He's got a puncher's chance.
Body shots.
Yeah, those do not look right.
Maximov is now double digits. Takedowns. He's at 11 and counting. Final 60 seconds. You think Soriano needs to end it to win it?
I don't know. Yeah, we don't know, right? We don't know.
Tough,
what's
tough
going
to
on.
Call. That's true. The first two rounds could have gone any direction.
There's a possibility, though, that Maximov has got 30-27.
Yes. According to the live odds, it was coin flip at the beginning of the round. That doesn't tell the whole story, but Maximov now.
I think if Soriano won a round, it was round one. I think two to three have been Maximov all day.
Final 30 seconds. Big body shot for Soriano, who's still carrying his power late in the fight. Can he find a big shot?
Got 5 seconds.
3 seconds.
Walking weird on that leg.
That's gonna do it. We'll keep it here. We'll show you some of the action and where we think Soriano might have suffered an injury. Nate Diaz, octagon side, liked what he saw. Nick Maximo, 7-0 entering this one. We'll see if he stays undefeated.
Help
Michael,
me,
here's
friends.
The injury in question.
Get back into the fight.
Sprawling out, look at, as he turns this way, kind of grimaces and lets out a little scream. Michael noticed it right away, he saw the grimace on his face, and this was just the story of the fight. Kuna defending a lot of this, and early in the fight did a really good job of defending, but look at the face, something really bothering him, and that's unfortunate to see whenever an injury happens. Maximov was relentless without pressure.
Well, took some big shots early and just
no one be
wrestled
right
his
now.
Way to perhaps a victory.
Some artillery
we'll get the scorecards when we come back.
Load the catapults!
Men. Let us show Pontus and Roman military architects are the best in the world!
Using all rules. Get out of the penalty box. 5G coverage like this. T-Mobile has more 5G bars in more places than ever. T-Mobile, more 5G bars in more places. Another reason T-Mobile is the leader in 5G.
It's the worst call in the history of sports. Dan Thomas never talked about that play. You ready?
I'm ready.
Just fumble.
Incomplete! Fumble! No!
This game is over, and you know it's over.
The Super Bowls all happened because it wasn't a fumble.
Had a tough rule. Never happened. A lot of people look back and think, well, what if?
It's up. Tomorrow at 8:30 p.m. Eastern on ESPN. And the next day on ESPN+.
UFC Fight Night is brought to you by DraftKings. Download the DraftKings Sportsbook app to bet on the UFC. Use promo code OCTAGON. DraftKings, the official sports betting partner of the UFC.
before the official decision of our co-main event, here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three, and Bob McCarthy scores the contest, score cards for decision. Mike Bell scores the contest. 29-28, Toriano. Douglas Crosby scores it. 30-27, Maximo. And Bob McCarthy scores the contest.
Guys, we are beating up.
For the winner, by split decision, and still undefeated, Nick Maximoff.
I'm here with the very happy Nick Maximoff. Nick Max, listen, split decision. How do you feel about
Impressive.
That?
I'm all right. He caught me at the good knee, so I couldn't see for shit for a minute, but I'm all good now.
Yeah, I think it was a punt.
Good. Props to him. He's good.
Did he surprise you with the wrestling defense? Because I know you came in planning to take him down, but he stood up to the test pretty well.
Yeah, no, it was all good. It was exactly what I expected. He's a tough line, so I got nothing but respect. I would like to get the finish, but it's all good.
Yeah, I heard you say to your coach there you couldn't really see anything once you got the cut. How badly were you affected?
I could see it. Just blood kept going in my eyes, so I couldn't see. But I could see, you know what I'm saying?
Well, you're still undefeated, 8-0, an impressive performance. When do you want to get back in here?
Oh, no, but shout out to the Nick Diaz Academy, Nick Diaz Army. My coach is Randy Spence, Lucas Camaza, my training partner, Luciano. Everyone over here, Chris, Nate, all my homies. 209 all the way to 530, Chico, California, stand up.
Nick Maximoff, ladies and gentlemen.
There you go, 8-0 for Nick Maximoff, who gets it done to go 2-for-2 in the octagon. Does so with the co-main event spotlight tonight against Puna Soriano.
Yeah, that's a big win for Nick Maximoff to come out here, especially to have Nate and the crowd and his team with him. And it was grueling. He really got tested. And that's what we've seen time and time again from Maximoff. I think that finish will come from him one day.
All right. We'll see what's next for him. Meanwhile, team prelims get the action going from Texas next Saturday night on ESPN. We'll get the opportunity.
But Canada did their thing tonight. So what's up, Canada? We're representing Nigeria. I'm representing Nigeria. And just a big thanks to everybody supporting me. And Mean Hakeem is back.
Mean Hakeem is back indeed. Ladies and gentlemen, put it together. Mean Hakeem Dawodu.
Well, we showed you that list that featherweight wins since 2018. And he's right there with Danny Ige, the champ, Volkanovski, Giga Chikadze's up there. That's a good list to be on. Dawodu standing out, makes it 3-1 for Canadians. He was trying to think of Alexis Davis as well, who got the victory.
He would refuse some help.
Dam, about 45 minutes down the road.
No permanent damage.
Nevada and Arizona. And
I'm not a good guy. I'm a villain. I want to take what you have. I want to break what you are. If you have something good in life, I want to take it from you. This is who I am. It's not something to be proud of, but I'm a villain, dude, and you are a victim.
Believe the time is now to make a move at bantamweight. Only one gets his wish granted tonight. And cause violence.
Seeing someone show fear is one of the most intoxicating things. When you hit a human being and you see its conscience just like flash out for a quick second, it is a drug and I'm addicted to it. I can go in there and put Jack away. I think I deserve a title shot. That's what I want.
The last couple of years has been a roller coaster. A lot of changed opponents. So much. But right now,
big elbows here.
Oh,
nice shot. Nice shot. Oh,
nice
shot.
And I truly, truly believe that I can beat that.
Big power shots from Hermanson.
The most dangerous guy in the world to have on top of you. I really don't think that there is anybody that has the game that I have. 2022 is going to be my time. It's going to be my year. After I beat Sean Strickland, I'm just one fight away from the title.
I am a force to be reckoned with. I am a title contender.
I think we're going to have a dogfight. Once I start touching his face, you're going to see the coward come out and you're going to try to wrestle him.
When people say that grappling is my power, it seems to me like you're afraid of that part of the game. I'm not capable of fighting coming back. I am.
Jack commands him with a final submission.
Your grappling game isn't in my head. I don't even think of you as a ground fighter. I just think of you as a victim.
trouble.
I just don't want to beat Jack. I want to destroy Jack. Fourth or fifth round finish. It's going to be bloody.
Motorcycle accident late 2018. Ultimately, he was able to fight back. He was a welterweight. He moved up to the middleweight division. Then the question was, how good can he be up a weight class? Now, Michael Bisping, the only question seems to be, how high can he go, and will he fight for a championship? Because since returning to 185 pounds, he's 4-0, and he's the favorite in this main event matchup tonight.
Well, that motorcycle accident that you mentioned, that is pivotal. What happened with the story of Sean Strickland, because he had mixed results. He was doing okay, but he said when he was involved in that accident, he got paid out some compensation, a lot of money. So that took away the pressure of fighting, because obviously he was doing it for financial reasons, and now he does it for pleasure. And now, listen, as we know, if you listen to the sound bites from Sean, he does do it for pleasure. He does get off on it. He does enjoy this.
You can't help me if you want.
I've known him for a long time. He has always been this way.
All right.
He's a relentless trainer. He's always running. He's always in the gym. He's a very, very good jiu-jitsu, by the way. But he said, for this camp, and he said, so far, he's doing fantastic things, and he's got a really good chance of winning this fight, and perhaps fighting for the belt soon.
Yeah, if he can go out there and be decisive tonight, he has absolutely every right to start calling for the title fight. If he doesn't get it, I mean, we don't know. We don't make those decisions, but if you're Sean Strickland, that's what's next. When you're on this kind of a winning streak, looking as good as you've been looking, that's obviously the next step for him. And, you know, he always talks about not caring about anything other than just the violence and the fighting. But that's what's getting him attention. So in a lot of ways, him just being him is what's making him sell right now. It's what's making people want to see him. So he's got to keep it going.
And he's a favorite in this matchup against Jack Hermans.
It's 2 months.
Representing Norway and Sweden, Jack the Joker Hermansson makes his 29th pro appearance in Las Vegas tonight. Paul, he's gone from European prospect to keep our eye on to contender pretty quickly. The statement was made in his first UFC main event a couple of years ago against Jacare Souza, and he's now competed amongst the top 10 with regularity, experience that he hopes to lean on against Sean Strickland tonight.
Yeah, absolutely. Jack Hermansson has now been in there and tested himself against some of the best middleweights in the world. And this is just another step for him to get towards that title.
That is what he wants.
That is what he has always wanted. Always wanted. There are some guys out there that don't talk about the title very much. Jack Hermansson is not that guy. He is in this game to become the UFC middleweight champion of the world. No doubt about it. He's got all the skills. He's very aggressive on the feet when he wants to be. And I think he's going to have to tune into that. I think he's going to have to plug into that side of himself tonight when facing an animal like Sean Strickland. He's got to have the stand-up skills to be able to trade with him. Jiu-jitsu, he's got to get past the striking skills of Strickland.
Good, and that means you're fucked.
And let us shed blood together.
Sean, it's all right. Like he's a psychopath. You're going to live. He wants to kill somebody inside the octagon. At the end of the day, he's just a man, right? And Jack Hermansson has been in there with Jack Hermansson. He's dragged all them people. He has the stand-up, he has the jiu-jitsu and the wrestling to win.
for this fight is interesting because it's two guys that do not look for animosity pre-fight. Jack Hermanson is as smiley as a contender as we have, but the intensity when they get in there is unmatched.
That intense. I mean, Jack is scary when he's done. Sean's always just a bit scary. But Jack, yeah, you see him smiling, he jokes, he's always messing with his teammates, having fun. But he is serious when he gets inside of the octagon.
That right is now. Out the window right now as Sean Strickland and Jack Hermanson are ready for five rounds or less in our main events here at the Apex. Tail of the tape, Hermanson, 3 years older than the American Sean Strickland. Both fighters 6'1" tall. The 1.5-inch edge in reach lies with the Norwegian Jack Hermanson. Setting the table one final time, Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the man.
Happy retirement to the greatest of all time.
The Nevada State Athletic Commission, Chairman Stephen J. Klubeck, Executive Director Jeff Mullen, our three judges scoring this contest at Octagon side on. Derek Lilly, Zali Amato, and Junichiro Kamijo. The action begins. A referee in charge of the octagon, Herb Dean. And now, for those in attendance and UFC fans from Las Vegas, the moment you've all been waiting for, live from UFC Vegas in Las Vegas.
Sean Strickland ranked one spot lower at 7, but he is the favorite at minus 220 in the matchup. UFC main event, second straight for Sean Strickland. Standouts. Hermanson's in the white, Strickland's in the black. Strickland has found a home here in Las Vegas. Extreme Couture, Eric Nixick, the coach in his corner, really found something with that camp there. And he certainly likes to fight the Apex, get a home game, and with less of a full arena, more trash talk.
Well, you can literally walk in the gym in 5 minutes on foot. So it is a home game, big time. And when you look at Sean, what you see is predominantly that left hand, that jab. He's going to pump that out over and over again. We were talking to Paul and I, and said, I didn't fancy what Sean does. Here and there, and then if there's a separation, he will swing with some hooks.
Right now you see Manson really invested early in that calf kick.
Manson said he would be happy to exchange that if he was Strickland, but on his terms. Wants to be careful to not fight on Sean Strickland's game plan. And there he shoots in for a takedown.
That's what he was always going to do. We could stand and say that I'm going to stamp Sean all night. I don't buy it for a second. I don't. This is how Romanson wins his fights. Look at the fight against Edmund Shabazian.
Yep.
I think sometimes in the fighters' minds, all of our minds, guys that competed at this level, you want to do those things. You want to support.
Yes.
It comes down to your instincts. And what you train to do is going to take over. Nice job here.
Logan Strickland right back to his feet.
Yeah, this is key. If Jack struggles now,
yeah,
I don't think that's going to get any better as the fight goes on.
No, he's got to be careful with his gas tank. He's got 5 rounds trying to get these takedown over and over. He's taking slow speed.
Strickland able to fight that one off as they return to the center. Round one.
That's where they're holding him. Looks like they're preparing to execute him and his Praetorians. No time to waste.
Jack needs to push forward first. He needs to get Sean on the back foot. Sean's planting his feet and using that jab really well. Gonna put him on the back foot. Of course, he's trying to mix in the takedowns as well. That will assist.
See most people commenting there. They have that 10-9 for Hermanson down one.
Yeah, and I
landed
think
all the leg kicks. That's really all that's really happened. Attempted takedowns, good defense from Strickland. But I feel like Sean is just taking his time. And there's five rounds here for these guys to fight.
And he talked to us about how he prefers three-round fights because he can sprint harder for 15 minutes.
So you see,
be able to stay at the same level over 25.
Yeah, he's kind of coasting right now. He's taking his time, but look for the momentum to build in a fight. You start chipping away when you're having success. You wear them down, and then when their defenses get low, they get more tired and you do more damage. That's when you start to pour on the pressure.
Easy defense for Strickland on the takedown attempt from Hermanson.
Yeah, it seemed like Jack didn't fully commit to that one. And that's smart. If you shoot in on a takedown and it's not there and you know it as a fighter, back out, look for another chance. Don't force the issue. And that's not to say that if you're a wrestler and you chain your attempts together, I'm not saying that. He was so far out from that one. He's like, I'm not even gonna put myself in a bad position.
Come on, there's fighting to be done.
So far out of range with that combination as well. Swinging a fresh arrow.
You alive? Good. Let's get you out of here.
Thank you. Lead the way. About time you came. Let's go.
That's nice.
Manson, probably his best combination of the fight.
Jack was right. He said, I'm not afraid to stand and exchange. That's what he's doing.
Strickland's using that double jab, following it up with the right.
I hate to say it, if he can't take it down, he's got no choice.
Yeah, but Sean's got to start getting busier with the punches.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, nice body kick there from Hermanson. And the defense is there.
Well, but not the best takedown attempt, you know, with respect. He's shooting from a little far out. So that's allowing Sean to defend quite easily. Step back, lowering his hips. There's a nice body shot.
Good aim!
Strickland, of course, made his presence known as a middleweight when he was trash talking with Jack Marshman for all 15 minutes of that fight.
I felt so sorry for Jack Marshman in that fight.
But he's been quiet since then. You know, he hasn't kind of...
I don't know. He was talking a little in the Dubai Hall fight. I think.
So far, silent.
Silence.
To go.
See, the thing is, in that Marshman fight, he had his number. He was picking him apart.
Right.
So then you can't afford to start having a little fun. When the stakes are high like this, when it's very evenly matched, and neither man has, you know, established dominance yet, you ain't got time for that. No time for showboating and proving that you're the man and you're really
gonna find your way into the fight first.
You better not get knocked out.
You see the difference in the attack, Strickland mostly to the head.
Think again.
For Mithridates.
But the striking numbers are still very, very close. 1 minute to go, round two. Another jab that catches the target for Strickland.
Sean needs to follow it up with the right hand though. Start putting some combinations together. Cut the cage off. Go to the fight now. Jack's going to exit to the left. See what I mean? Then cut the cage off. Cross it back. Then let go. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2 to the body. Inside low kick. 1, 2.
Sean's starting to pick up the kicking game here too. He's landed a few good left kicks to the body. Starting to use that front kick. I think that's going to open things up for him more. If he can start putting things together with the kicks and then his punches.
Final 5 seconds of round number two. Oh! Right from Strickland.
Big shot.
There's the horn as Strickland was going to let him back to his feet. If there was any question about that round two, Strickland ended it.
Just took that one.
Hey, you having some fun?
Yeah, you said fun?
Holy shit.
Beautiful. Hey, listen, I just need to keep poking with the jab here. Good job on changing the level with the body shot. That's going to keep investing, right? So on that midline body shot, reload it. Hey, you having fun? Holy fuck.
Doesn't need the full mount.
I like that, Teddy Atlas. He's so right. Strickland just does such a good job of slipping, just steps just out of range, but he stays in so that he can re-engage when he wants to on his terms. But if you notice throughout this fight, especially with the punching exchanges, he really doesn't eat much shots.
So nice. That one that put him down there, it wasn't actually a close. It looked like you were trying to take him down, but he had a good takedown that he was blocked by the forearm. But still,
judges don't know that.
The judges do not see that.
Coming up next Saturday, mixed martial arts at the highest level will be on display in Houston. It's UFC 271, Israel Adesanya, Robert Whittaker, the championship rematch. You can only catch it on ESPN Plus next week. And that's a big thing with Nixik, right? You mentioned the short turn of the corner where Strickland was on his toes for the last 30 seconds of that corner. Nixik likes that for his fighters.
Play that we'll mental die game if we stay here.
Well, Nixik was on the stool. Well, yeah. Let him see you bouncing on your toes and ready to get back to work.
Well, yeah, because if you're on the other side, it can be demoralizing. You're starting to feel the pressure. You're starting to get tired. You're breathing heavy. And then you look across the octagon. You see a man that all week has spoken about wanting to kill someone in the octagon, and they're not even tired of them walking back and forth.
So, you need my help feeling. After all.
Stiff jab from Strickland.
This is good. Who are you? What he needs to
hear the speculatory of Legion. You're quite impressive yourself, Consul. The main assault should have taken.
I can fight to lead the way. Let us go and deal with that strutting cock, Mithridates.
Are you surprised that he's only attempted so far 4 takedowns?
No.
Hasn't really committed to keep going.
No, because they've been unsuccessful. And when they're unsuccessful, then what's the point of wasting energy?
Yeah, you start doubting yourself that you can even do it. And they haven't even, if they've been close, or if you got them down for a little bit,
yeah.
Strickland got back up, then you would see more attempts. But they really haven't even been that close. They've just been shucked off. And not a non-issue, really, for Sean.
And you allow yourself to be found, well, you find yourself in bad positions as well from sloppy takedown attempts. And it requires a lot of energy.
Strickland still working behind the jab and staying on the outside while Hermanson tries to figure out a way in.
Like even that, see how he just gets out of the way. He doesn't slide all the way back to the fence. He doesn't run around the cage. It's a battle of inches, really. Big body kick there. See, boom, there it is again.
Yeah, his movement is strong. To your point earlier, or I can't remember if you were saying it, Michael, Strickland just plays like this guy who only fights, I just want to brawl, but he is technically very sound.
Oh, absolutely. You know, his fundamentals particularly are very strong. Defensively good.
Hermanson in once again. And Strickland just staying out of danger. 1 minute to go, round number 3.
Yeah, Sean's essentially winning this fight with a jab, which is what he does in a lot of his fights. But typically by this point now, he's started to let go with some other combinations.
But if you're winning the first three rounds with the jab, and again, that first round was close. First round was close, but.